למטה למעלה מרכבות סתומות הולכות ומתגלגלות כל נעימות עולה ויורד פתק ומשתק בעולם אוי 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 Yo 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 Se hoko
Beautiful, Manny. That was great.
The song is even going to be better if it was a longer one. So anyway.
Yeah, that was only a little snippet of what Manny Santos and I do on a Friday night at Tony's place. And it was really beautiful song called Col
Gal Gal.
Gal Gal, which
it's from the
voice of the circle.
The voice of the circle, and it's from the Zohar. It's like a prayer.
Mm.
Yeah. And it's just like... This is what I do, the circle, you keep on going back in circle, closing a circle, going into a bigger circle. In my pursuit, in giving illuminations to the darkness that I have kind of trying to put some light into. And I think the light that I give into it is like encountering the strangers and the people, the communities, especially amongst the Jewish communities, because this is what I devoted my life into in the past 25, 30 years.
Amazing. And you've done something with the Greek community that's happening?
Yes. Well, recently, about a year and a half ago, Carol Gordon and I went to Greece. She did her film called Shiraz Journey, which is being shown now in Los Angeles Film Festival and just been in the Athens Film Festival. And at the same time, I took some photographs, and this is now going to be opened, supposedly, and I think at the end of June, in Athens, and in September in Saloniki for the Saloniki Arts Festival. So I am intending also to go to Greece in a few weeks from now and attend that.
And back to Poland.
Back to Poland.
A fabulous museum that only opened recently, the Museum of the Jewish People.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're doing an exhibition there next year to celebrate the 72nd anniversary of the uprising, the Warsaw uprising.
Warsaw uprising, yes. It's been a year. When I first saw the place, I thought that it's a beautiful place, except that architecturally it's a wonderful place.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, there's not much works that are being exhibited there. Some like really kind of like old works. A lot of it is virtual. It's like very modern.
Mm.
Amazing interior and all that sort of thing. So I dreamt that when I first saw it about 2 years ago when it was being built, I would like to do an exhibition here. So I think that there were two options. One is the old Museum of Jewish Institute or something like that, and this new place.
Mm-hmm.
So we are now preparing an exhibition for next year, which is going to go for about 6 months.
Yep.
And a book that goes with it. And
what's the book called?
The book would be, at the moment, we have a working title of, what's it called again? Tribes from the Sambatyon.
That's right.
And why Sambatyon? Because apparently it was in Sambatyon is where the lost tribes of Israel kind of disbanded, and then from there they went to different...
They spread all over the world.
Far-flung places of the world, yeah.
And there are still lost tribes, and that's what an ethnographer like you does.
And I'm still lost because I'm still looking for them. And, you know, I maybe have just, like, scanned the surface of it. And I'm still, you know, the more I go through it, what is underneath the surface are even more interesting.
Yeah, it's a life's work for you.
I think I would need more than a lifetime for that. You know, I hope that I live into 280 in order to continue what I'm doing, in order to cover at least a good kind of like different surfaces.
Well, you've got to get young people getting involved.
That's
with
what it is. You know, I've always kind of like loved to mentor people and then encourage people in order to continue, because, you know, once you become a witness, which I was a witness when I first went to Poland, you are an eternal witness. And you continue this legacy. And the only way for me to continue the legacy is to continue the work that I'm doing and show as much, from my point of view, the world of that void, of that absence, of that community as I encountered them in my day-to-day experience.
Well, I am so privileged, and the viewers must realize how rare it is to find Emmanuel Santos in Melbourne again these days, because you're always somewhere on some project. And whenever I saw you the other night, Friday night, we had a wonderful jam together. And we're going to end the show with another song.
Another song. Yeah. This is like the fitting song.
We're going
song
to do a Ladino song.
Like I'm the wandering token Jew.
Yeah, yes, you are.
I'm
you
be
are.
Singing you about are. This Ladino song, Nací en Alamo.
You are an honor. Jew.
A song that I have learned when I was traveling in South America on a boat from Manaus to Belém.
Fabulous. And while he's coming in, we're going to go out with a little song and see you next week. We've got Dvir Abramovich coming. Dr. Dvir Abramovich from the Anti-Defamation Committee. We're going to get serious. Serious, Joe. Thanks for watching. Shalom.
No tengo paisaje, yo menos tengo patria. Con mis manos juego fuego, con mi corazón te canto, las cuerdas de mi corazón.
Thank you.